Welcome to the HHS Online Bid Room. This training is broken up into two parts. Part 1 will explain how to gain access to the online bid room, and Part 2 will explain how to navigate the online bid room. Let's get started. The online bid room is your newest resource for submitting bids with Health and Human Services, or HHS. The HHS Online Bid Room gives you an easier way to submit a bid for open solicitations. You can use the Online Bid Room to submit a response to a solicitation for the Health and Human Services Commission, or HHSC, the Department of State Health Services, or DSHS, the Department of Family and Protective Services, or DFPS, and the Texas Civil Commitment Office, or TCCO. In order to get started with the HHS Online Bid Room, you will need two sets of login credentials. In other words, a username and a password. You can think of this like having to log into your cell phone and then having to log in separately to an app on your cell phone. To access the HHS Online Bid Room, you will need two sets of credentials for two sites. One for Enterprise Portal and a second one for the CAPS Financial System. Starting with gaining access to Enterprise Portal. Locate the Enterprise Portal at hhsportal.hhs.state.tx.us. If you are invited to bid on a solicitation, you can follow the link directly from your invitation email. Otherwise, you can find this link on the HHS website at hhs.texas.gov. The Online Bid Room webpage is under Business, then Contracting with HHS. On the HHS Enterprise Portal website, you will begin by selecting Register. Here, you will select the option, I represent a business or organization responding to an HHSC, DFPS, DSHS, OIG, or TCCO solicitation using the HHS Online Bid Room. Then select Next. From here, select a username. You will notice a green check mark or a red X indicating if the username you've selected is available. Once you select a username, you can continue by adding your first name and last name. Enter your email address, followed by a primary phone number, the type of primary phone number you provided, an optional secondary phone number, if applicable, and the type of secondary phone number, if provided. Next, select the type of address you are providing. Enter the street address, followed by the city, zip, country, state, and county. Next, add your company name and indicate if you have received credentials, a username and password for the HHS Online Bid Room, which would have been received in a separate email. Indicate the days and times you can be reached. Enter your tax identification number or federal employer identification number. Finally, carefully complete the CAPTCHA and select Next. Selecting Done will return you to the main login screen. Once your access to the Enterprise Portal has been approved, you will receive an email with login credentials. This could take up to 5 days, so allow yourself plenty of time. You're now ready to sign into the Enterprise Portal using your new credentials. On the Enterprise Portal home screen, add your username that you set up. Then, enter the password that was supplied to you in the email you received approving your access. Select Sign In. The first time you log into the Enterprise Portal, you will need to read and accept the Health and Human Services Acceptable Use Agreement. At the bottom of the form, check the box to indicate that you acknowledge that you have read and understand the agreement, then sign it using your first and last name that you provided when setting up your account. Select Next. From there, you will need to select a new password, paying attention to the password rules provided. Then, select Next. On the next screen, confirm your personal details, making any changes necessary. Then select Next. You are now logged into the Enterprise Portal. Now you're ready to sign in to the HHS Online Bid Room. If you are invited to bid on a solicitation, you have already received these credentials in a separate email. Otherwise, these credentials will be emailed to you after your registration for the Enterprise Portal is approved. Begin by selecting HHS Online Bid Room from the Applications area within Enterprise Portal. After entering the CAPS financial system, the Acceptable Use Policy window appears. You will need to read and accept the HHS Acceptable Use Agreement by selecting the I Agree button. Enter the username and password you received in the email notifying you of your approval for the CAPS Financials HHS Online Bid Room. Then select Sign In. After logging in, you'll need to select the link to Set Security Question for Password Recovery. Select a question and then enter a response for the question. Select OK to move forward. Next, select the link to review the acknowledgement for use of the HHS Online Bid Room. After reviewing, select OK. Then mark the checkbox and sign your first and last name to acknowledge your agreement. Select Submit. This will take you to the CAPS Financials homepage. From here, you will have to navigate to the Bid Room, also known as the Work Center. Then, you will be ready to start bidding. Part 2, Navigating the HHS Online Bid Room. Once you have logged in, you will be at the CAPS Financials homepage. From the top right, locate the compass icon. Select the compass. The nav bar or navigation bar opens. Select Menu. The menu opens. Select Manage Events and Place Bids. The Manage Events and Place Bids menu opens. Select HHS Online Bid Room. The HHS Online Bid Room opens. The home screen of the Online Bid Room is also known as the Work Center. On the left-hand side, you will see five tabs. Solicitation Posting, WC or Work Center Instructions, All Open Bid Events, Account Management, and Links. The first tab is the Solicitation Posting tab. This tab is where you will post solicitations. The second tab is the Work Center Instructions tab. This tab provides instructions on how to use the Work Center. Please note, these are instructions on how to use the Work Center specifically and not how to submit a bid for a particular solicitation. The third tab is the All Open Bid Events tab. This will show you all open bid events on which you can bid. The fourth tab is the Account Management tab. Here, you have the option to set security questions for a forgotten password hint. You will have the option to select from several different questions and provide a response you will use in the instance that you ever forget your password. The fifth and final tab is the Links tab. The Links tab will provide you a variety of helpful links. Selecting the arrow will minimize these tabs to the left. To view open events, select Search for Public or Other Invited Events to Bid On link. This will open the View Events and Place Bid area. Or, from the nav bar, you can select Menu, then View Events and Place Bids to open the page in full. To search an event, enter an event ID, event name, event type, or event status. For this example, I'll use an event ID. Then select Search. The results will show at the bottom. You can also save your search criteria by selecting the Save Search Criteria link. Here, you will have the option to enter a description or name for the saved search. Select Save to save the criteria for later use. To open a saved search, select the drop-down arrow next to the Use Saved Search field. Select the item to search. Once you've located the solicitation on which you wish to bid, you can select the Event ID link. This will take you to the landing page or event details page for the selected solicitation. To view the solicitation package for this event, select the View Event Package link on the far right. This will bring up all package attachments. Select View to download a particular document. Depending on the browser you are using, you can then open and download the document using the appropriate program on your computer. Scroll to the bottom of the page and select OK. When you're ready to bid on event, select Bid on Event from the Event Details page. A message appears asking, "Default the bid quantity for each line item to be equal to the requested quantity?" Please read the entire message to make the proper selection. For this example, I will select Yes. This will open the bidding screen. Scroll down the page and pay attention to items that require a response, which are noted with a red star. Here, you can also select to add comments or attachments. To add an attachment, select the Add Comments or Attachments link. Select Upload. Select Choose File, then select the file you wish to upload. Select Open. Select Upload. You can add a description for the file you've uploaded. To add additional attachments, select Add New Attachments. To delete an attachment or to delete an attachment placeholder, select Delete. Select OK to confirm that you wish to delete that row. When you're done adding comments and attachments, select OK to return to the main bid screen for the solicitation. Add your unit bid price for each item as listed on the solicitation page. Remember, this is unit bid price, not total price. You can see total price in the column indicated. Continue adding your unit bid price for each item. Some solicitations allow you the option to not bid on a particular item or items. If this is the case, select No Bid next to the item you do not wish to bid on. Once you've finished filling out all of the bid amounts, select Validate Entries at the bottom right of the bid page. If there are errors, an error message window will appear, select OK. Scroll to the top of the page to review the error. Make any necessary corrections. Once you have confirmed there are no issues, select Submit Bid. You will receive a confirmation that your bid has been successfully submitted. It is recommended that you keep a copy of this page for your records. When you're finished, select OK. For some bids, you may also need to upload an XML bid response. To begin this process, select Upload XML Bid Response. Please make special note that this applies only to invitation for bids or IFBs. On the next screen, you will select XML File. Select Choose File, then select the file you wish to upload. This file would have been originally accessed from the solicitation package completed, then saved with the same file name prior to upload. Once the file is attached, select Upload. If the file is successfully uploaded, you will return to the main bid screen for this solicitation. You can then proceed with validating your entries, and if there are no errors, submit your bid. This concludes our coverage of the HHS Online Bid Room key functionality. We invite you to view the user's guide and the frequently asked questions or FAQ document for more information. Both documents can be found on the HHS Online Bid Room page of the HHS website at hhs.texas.gov. Happy bidding!